Well, most of us read food labels. I know I do. We look at the calories and the fat grams and the protein, but there is something else in food that parents especially need to look for.
We're talking about food dyes. The Center for Science and the Public Interest has been pushing for a ban on 8 artificial dyes, claiming that they can severely affect children's behavior. And just last month, the Food and Drug Administration took up this issue.
Of the 12 children on this preschool playground, 3 of them have problems with food dyes. Davis McFarland is one of them.
I went to a birthday party and Davis went and picked out a cupcake, the one that had all the frosting with red and blue and yellow. And after we left the party, he was very hyper, very impulsive, and just really couldn't control his body. It was a behavior I'd never seen before.
It was behavior Robert Scaglione had seen before in his son, Sebastian.
We know it's not just our child. We see other children with it, and we talk to other people. You'll hear them randomly talking, and you're like, there's another kid with the same problem our kid has.
Artificial dyes are found in hundreds of foods, like chips, chocolate syrup, salad dressing, yogurt, cereal, and cold medicine. Just last month, an FDA panel investigated whether products with food dyes should have warning labels.
It was a hotly debated issue, a narrow vote, 8-6. The panel decided food packages don't need warning labels, that more evidence is needed. But the panel did agree with studies that show for certain children, hyperactivity and other behavioral problems are exacerbated by food dye, something our family discovered years ago.
3 years ago, I told you about my daughter Caroline, how red dye caused extreme changes in her behavior, uncontrollable crying and aggressiveness.
Are the cucumbers good?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Put them down.
You want more cucumbers?
Yeah.
All right. Everybody loves cucumbers.
These days, there are no dyes in her diet.
Have you gotten pretty good at reading labels, do you think?
Yeah. And now I know, when I first read a label, then I know what I cannot have and what I can have.
Even though the FDA panel voted against food warning labels, clinical psychologist Dr. Miles Cooley says parents need to do what's best for their family.
There are probably many children who eat it and they have no issues at all, right?
I think that's the case. That's the case with a lot of things in our environment. The reactions are what we would call idiosyncratic. They affect certain people and not others. The difficulty we have is predicting who they're going to affect.
You're going to climb down? So how is he now when he doesn't have the dye?
Great, great, well behaved. Yeah. You know, he's still a boy, very active, but not the concerning behaviors that I was seeing.
There you go.
For us, taking the color out of our food has been music to our ears. At home, life is more peaceful.
Fist bump. All right. You know, as I mentioned in my original report, manufacturers in Europe put warning labels on food, or they use a lot of natural dyes like beet juice, which, Victor, is something that a lot of more food makers here in the States are doing. But yeah, natural dyes, they cost a lot more money. So that's really, that comes down to one of the big issues.
Yeah, let's talk about the FDA, because you mentioned that. At this point, this is not a moot issue for them.
It's not. You know, everyone on the panel that reviewed it, except one person, all of them agreed that more studies need to be done. So hopefully that will happen in the future to let people know what could happen to some children or what may be causing some bad behavior.
All right, so we have to read those labels carefully.
Yep.
All right.